piece I'm going to perform is a very special one. It is called With and Without, and it was composed for the exhibition Containers at the Galway Arts Festival in 2000 by the amazing composer James O'Leary. I think everybody here knows James. And we have the incredible opportunity to have the composer, Jane, here with us. And I think she would love to share a few words about this piece with us. So please, Jane.
Thank you, Pablo. Thank you. I was so delighted when Pablo said that he'd like to play this piece in the program today. So I haven't heard it for a very long time, and it was written, as he said, 15 years ago, which seems like centuries ago. But it has such a strong Galway connection that it's fantastic that you're taking it back to Galway and giving it life again. So I just want to tell you about its origins very briefly. It was part of an exhibition called Containers at Galway Arts Festival, and my good friend Hilary Morley Clark and Sean McCrum were the curators of this. And in fact, it was the first time I met Hilary. We've worked together a lot since then and become good friends. But it was an incredible exhibition where a number of craftsmen and designers were invited to create objects around the theme of containers, and a number of composers were also invited to relate to these objects and create music to go with each object. Paul Rowe was the performer who played all the pieces at the exhibition, and Paul is Pedro's teacher. So here's how it all comes together. Anyway, my artist was Brian McGee, and his idea was to create an amphora. And for those of you who might not be sure what an amphora is, I had to study it a bit at the time. He says it was the ubiquitous container of the classical world. And indeed, it had this kind of a shape where it didn't have a bottom and they stacked into each other, but they contained the liquids. And the important elements were that Brian's object was made of ceramic and it had two handles, and it had this isn't his, I don't have a picture of his object unfortunately, but it's the shape, and it had a point at the bottom. Now, he had the idea that he would create little miniatures of this, it was large like this, and he put it in a bed of sand, and he had miniatures inside it and also outside it, around it, on the bed of sand. So this really interested me, the idea that there were hidden objects inside and also outside, and the relationship between the miniature and the large. So, and he said in his description that he was attracted to the beauty of its form, and indeed it was the kind of smooth curved lines and shapes that attracted me. So just to say of what happens in the music, there are little miniature motifs that are echoing the larger shape, but the overall shape, it's the only piece I've ever written with such a clear design. Starts with the lowest notes. Can you maybe just give us the lowest? And goes to the very highest. There is a kind of painful little peak.